15 of the world's strangest New Year's traditions. Pancake everyone, dear friends, when the year comes to the end, usually you want to reflect on it, and then wish it goodbye and meet the new one, because it is sure to be better than the previous one, and it is desirable to celebrate the holiday in such a way that it would be unusual and would be remembered for a long time. For those who are tired of traditional celebrations and want to try something new, we offer several options, just in case you like it. And before we start the video, we advise you to subscribe to our channel and like it, so you'll help in the growth of our channel, and it will allow more people to enjoy our videos. Procession of the Cuckers, Bulgaria. Procession of the Cuckers is when men dress up in frightening masks. The masquerade procession is a surviving pagan rite that is popular in Bulgaria. The men dress up in frightening masks, put bells on their belts, put on goat furs turned inside out, and make a carnival procession with dances. The purpose of the puppets is to drive out evil spirits, and such games are usually held on New Year's Eve and Maslenitsa. Meeting the new year wearing the right color underpants is common in Latin American countries. There is an omen in some Latin American countries. If you choose the right color of underpants and meet the holiday in them, good luck in the new year is assured. If you are looking for passion, romance, and love, your choice is red. Yellow underwear guarantees prosperity, and white, peace, harmony, and happiness. Jumping into the new year and breaking dishes. Denmark. In Denmark on New Year's Eve, they like to jump in from the highest place in the house. It's also where they like to smash dishes. On the last day of December, the Danes like to have a good time and fool around. And they have an interesting New Year's Eve tradition. With the chime of the clock, you have to find the highest available point, be it a chair, couch, table, climb onto it, and with the last beat, literally jump into the new year. In addition, the new year is a time to strengthen friendships. So all year long, they collect old porcelain plates and mugs to break them on the porch of relatives or close friends. They say it brings good luck, and the more shards on your porch, the better. Greetings for cows, Belgium. In Belgium, cows are greeted on New Year's Eve, probably to make the chocolate taste better. Belgian milk chocolate is known the world over, and cows are treated with special reverence in this country. Belgian farmers have a tradition of getting up early on the 1st of January and going to their cows to wish them a Happy New Year. Of course, they treat other farm animals with the same respect. Perhaps this attitude is the key to brilliant results. Fortune-telling on molten tin, Finland. To find out what awaits in the new year, in Finland they predict on molten pewter. It is melted in a small horseshoe, poured into a bucket of cold water, and looked at the resulting picture. It takes a real expert to explain what this or that shape of the frozen figure means. If the shape resembles a heart or a ring, it is to marriage. If it looks like a boat or a ship, then it is to travel. And if it looks like a pig, the end of your diet. Because it means that there will be a lot of food. Takanakui Wrestling Festival, Peru. To relieve the year's accumulated stress and fatigue, it is best to take a trip. And the little village of Santo Tomas in Peru might be a good option. There, every year in the final days of December, the Takanakui Festival takes place, when all of the locals get together to dance, drink, and beat the crap out of each other. Yeah, fighting without rules is the best way to have fun. Everyone participates. Women, men, children, and even the elderly. It's a time when everything from a stolen sheep to spoiled beer gets out. These fights are officially allowed, and no one is responsible for the injuries. In Estonia on New Year's Eve, people sit down to eat 7 times. Whoever loves to eat. In remembrance of the time when food was scarce and hard to come by, Estonians have made it a tradition to indulge in gluttony at least one day a year. On New Year's Eve, they sit down at the table 7 times. According to a superstition, this will ensure prosperity and satiety in the coming year. And some people don't even eat 7 times a day, but 9 or 12. There's an explanation too. 7, 9, and 12 are considered lucky numbers in Estonia. Malanka holiday, Ukraine. In Ukraine, there is an entire holiday devoted to dancing, songs, and fistfights. And they also celebrate the New Year twice there. In Ukraine, as in Russia, the New Year is celebrated twice. on the 1st of January according to the Gregorian calendar, and the 14th of January according to the Julian calendar. In Iceland, at 10 p.m., all inhabitants sit down to watch a comedy show, which has been on every year since 1966. This is how people in Iceland celebrate New Year's Eve. At 6 p.m., they turn on the radio to listen to the pulpit mass broadcast, and at 8 p.m., they go outside to watch the big bonfires. In the past, all old, unnecessary things had to be thrown into these fires to clean out the house for the new year. Nowadays, the tradition is maintained by occasionally throwing some old sock or shoe into the fire, as a sort of symbolic gesture. But the strangest thing comes afterward. At 10 p.m., all of Iceland gathers in front of their televisions to watch a New Year's Eve comedy show. And the tradition began as far back as 1966. Surveys show that 90% of the population watches the show, and the next day everyone discusses it, bred to every home, Ireland. Ireland loves noise. And so on New Year's Eve, everyone walks around with loaves of bread and banging on doors and walls. They say it's for good luck. The Irish love to celebrate the New Year, and they do it noisily, gathering the whole family or large groups of friends. They certainly know how to celebrate. Ireland has many ancient traditions and superstitions, and one of them will seem strange to a foreigner. Its idea is to walk and knock on doors and walls of houses with a loaf of bread. This is supposed to bring prosperity, wealth, good luck, and bread to every home. Night in the Cemetery, Chile. A small town in Chile has one of the strangest New Year's traditions. Locals gather in a cemetery to celebrate the New Year, with relatives and loved ones who have passed away. This tradition is a couple of hundred years old and originated, according to legend, when a few children came to the cemetery on the last day of the year to be near their deceased father. Now, every year on the 31st of December at 11 p.m., the mayor opens the gates of the cemetery and thousands of people rush in. The cemetery is beautifully lit, and classical music is played. Throwing things out the window, South Africa. One of the world's most crime-ridden urban neighborhoods, the Hillbro neighborhood in Johannesburg, has also become famous for an extremely dangerous New Year's Eve tradition that began in the 1990s. Residents greet the New Year by throwing everything from old microwave ovens to beds out of the windows of tall buildings, much to the annoyance of the police. Residents store items to be thrown out of windows in advance, to provide themselves with material for a long time. This practice was made illegal in 2011, but even patrolling the streets didn't save some unfortunate passerby from a refrigerator dumped from above, trying to hear animals. Romania. In Romania on New Year's Day, people strain to hear horses or other animals. There is a belief in Romania that animals know human language and a related New Year's Eve tradition, especially popular with farmers. They go to the stables and strain as hard as they can, in an attempt to hear what sounds the horses or other animals are making. If they suddenly hear animals talking to them in human language, it is a bad sign, and the next year will not be easy. But if they do not hear anything, that's a sign of good luck. Round the underwater Christmas tree, Russia. In Irkutsk, Russia, divers celebrate the New Year underwater, and even dance around the Christmas tree. It is one of the most amazing New Year's traditions in the world. It was started by some fearless divers from Irkutsk. But who else would have the idea to dive to the bottom of Lake Baikal with a Christmas tree and champagne? The idea is to plant a Christmas tree in the ground to make it look like a real one, dress it up, drink wine, and make a round dance. This tradition is now 20 years old, and last year there was even a Santa Claus to hand out gifts. Mass Kiss, Venice. In Venice, crowds of lovers come every year for the New Year, and not to walk around and see the city, but because there is a kissing marathon at that time. The tradition is not the strangest, but it is certainly the most enjoyable, both for locals and tourists. The kissing marathon takes place every year at midnight on the 31st of December at St. Mark's Square in Venice, and every year crowds of romantic couples gather for this event. They gather around 10 p.m. under the tower with the big chimes, and start practicing kissing well in advance. in order to perform this number again for an encore, at midnight to the sound of the fireworks. The event was first held in 2008, and won an international prize for Best New Year's Eve Celebration. So if you can and you have someone to make out with, you should go to Venice for New Year's Eve. Every country has something unusual or strange. And now you know that New Year's Eve is not only a celebration of the outgoing year and the meeting of the new year, but also funny rituals from different countries. Would you like to participate in any of these events? Let us know in the comments down below. This is Pancake with you. Pancake cheer and see you all again.